Today is the final day of the World Solar Challenge.
Exciting race.
Yeah, it's really exciting. There are three teams within 30 minutes. I don't know if it ever happened. I think not.
In one of the closest races in years, the top three solar teams, Vattenfall, Agoria, and Tokai, are starting just minutes apart. But only one will bring home the trophy.
There's obviously a bit of tension in the air because you know it's so close. We've worked 14 months every day, 70 to 80 hours a week to cross the finish line first. It will mean everything.
Everyone is ready to take the cup home, I'm sure of that. It's going to be all in today, all cards on the table. It's going to be super exciting.
Today is the final day and the big day.
It's all come down to this. I am here in Adelaide, where the World Solar Challenge 2019 will end. It has been quite the journey. 4.5 days, traveling 3,000 kilometers, nearly 1,900 miles, cutting across a continent, and some of the most harsh, deadliest landscape on Earth. 300 kilometers up the road at the final control stop, the top three teams are starting based on their arrival times yesterday.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
Defending champions Vattenfall are first out of the gate.
We're just gonna go. We're gonna get to Adelaide as fast as we can. We're planning not to be overtaken.
Team Agoria from Belgium is only 2 minutes behind Vattenfall.
Those guys have won 7 or 8 times already, so the stress of losing it now is gonna be insane as well with them. We saw cracks with them yesterday, making mistakes. So, I mean, I think we really have the advantage here. We just have to stay cool, do our thing.
Team Tokai is starting 19 minutes behind Agoria, but can't be counted out of the running. They've been gaining relentlessly over the last 2 days, moving from 7th to 3rd.
We have enough energy for the car to make it in. In fact, we have too much energy because of the speed restrictions yesterday. So we'll be going at full speed all the way into the finish line. The Japanese, they just keep increasing the speed every day, and I think making some of these European guys nervous.
In fourth position, the American team Michigan is still within striking distance. They're about 90 kilometers back.
We don't know exactly where all the vehicles are, but we did hear that they're pretty packed together near Port Augusta. We're hoping that means they over-race a little bit and they try to do lots of passes today, and hopefully maybe we can close some ground.
Back up front, Tokai is already making up time. But you can never underestimate the reigning champions. Vattenfall has won 7 of the last 9 races here.
Our cars are looking really good, but there are right now a lot of good cars. Tokai, but also the Belgian team, is also a very good car.
Vattenfall is before us, but we think that their battery is more empty than ours. That's a guess of us.
In the final leg of a solar car race, teams use as much battery as they can to sprint into the finish. But if a battery's charge gets too low, this can be dangerous.
So everyone's pushing the limits of their cars and their packs, and so if you start getting towards the low end of the pack where you're running out of energy and kind of pushing it a bit further, your battery can start getting a bit hot.
When batteries heat up, they can become unstable.
I'm so glad you're okay.
As the Stanford team found out on the first day of the race.
Everyone away.
To stay safe, teams with low battery must watch their speed.
Vattenfall is slowing down, really slowing down.
I think if we would win, that would be a main factor why we would win.
You want me to snake out to the right side?
With nearly a full battery, Agoria is slowly gaining on Vattenfall. But with only a few hours left in the race, it's not clear they'll have enough time to catch the leader.
The anxiety is that we have to overtake Delft right now, so we need a bit of luck.
Of Delft that something happened. I had to go to the side of the road, but I'm not sure why.
So we'll be merging behind their convoy and then monitor their speed.
Up ahead, the reason Vattenfall is pulling over becomes painfully clear as their cabin fills with smoke.
Stand by.
Stopped.
In a matter of seconds, Team Vattenfall's dreams are fully ablaze. And the finality is inescapable.
Het is eigenlijk verschrikkelijk wat er is gebeurd. Nu na X is afgebrand. Het is wel duidelijk dat we niet meer de finish halen in Adelaide.
This morning we thought we were going to finish first and now we have no car to cross the finish line with. The whole team is quite devastated about it. So we try to push each other through this experience and try and stay positive, but it's very difficult too if everything you've worked for is sort of gone.
As the Vattenfall car is reduced to nothing but ash, Agoria passes by and into the lead.
The moment you pass another car being broken or facing something very difficult, or the first thought is always, is the pilot okay? And then it hits you like, oh, it's their work. And I felt sick and like, oh, that's terrible for them. And yeah, it's such a weird, yeah. I don't want to wish it upon anyone.
Up ahead of the leaders, Agoria's eyes car, or scout vehicle, reacts to Vattenfall's fate on social media.
You see the smoke? What? What? Their car is still on fire.
It's completely gone.
It's still 100 kilometers drive to Adelaide. We overtook Vattenfall because they had a burn in their battery pack. So we're in first position right now. That's quite exciting.
With Agoria taking over the lead, Tokai moves into second place. While the Belgians have had a remarkable stroke of luck, they're now being hunted down by the team from Japan.
We know that Tokai is also chasing us and are actually getting closer.
We have heard that they're driving max speed while we're driving more safe.
An hour back from the leaders, Michigan is arriving at the final control stop, Port Augusta. With Vattenfall out of the race, they've moved into the top three.
We started this morning in fourth place. We're now in third.
But there's one major factor that could still keep Michigan from a podium finish. 2 days ago, their lead car blocked Tokai from passing, a possible violation of race rules.
You! That's up, man.
But the jury is still out.
We didn't know if there were some penalties related to the driving conduct of some vehicles, and that was
It was pretty frustrating.
In the World Solar Challenge, penalties are levied as forced timeouts from the race. If officials decide to rule against Michigan, it could allow the car behind them, top Dutch, to catch up and knock them out of third place.
Our strategy will not change as a result of this. The best way to win is to just focus on your own car and keep going.
I score. There's a Roadworks here.
Agoria's lead on Tokai is very slim. Now just 15 minutes separates the front two cars. And Roadwork is just the kind of complication that could bring Tokai right behind them. So they look for a little help from the crew.
There's a solar convoy coming up.
Did you communicate with your guy that we can get past without waiting too much? Okay, cool. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
If we are going to end up catching some of the teams in front of us, we're going to have to push our car to the limit.
We knew that the competition was going to be the hardest we've ever faced.
You never know what's going to happen on this last day.
Despite talking to the flagman, Agoria still has to slow down to safely pass through the construction, losing valuable time. But by the time Tokai reaches the block, the heavy equipment has cleared, and they sail right through, closing in on the leader.
As we get into these more dense areas by the city, we'll be sharing the road with all the normal traffic. That to me is a lot riskier. It's really stressful for us.
The end of the race is the most challenged because Adelaide is a very, very big traffic area. And also our battery is low, so that's a very hard point.
As both teams battle their way to the city center, Tokai is closing in, just minutes behind. The question is, can they catch them with only 2 kilometers to go? As the final minutes of the race tick away, Tokai's only chance of catching up is if Agoria gets snagged in the traffic lights. But at the last intersection before the finish line at Bragg Park, Agoria glides straight through.
World champions, baby! Okay.
What just happened? We became world champion. So I have no words for it.
What is the event to you?
The event is a challenge. It's a challenge to get here 3,021 kilometers. And if you get it, you already wins. And then the second thing is getting first. And that's what we saw today.
Tokai arrives just minutes behind in second place. After crossing the official finish line in Bragg Park, both teams move to the red carpet celebrations here in Victoria Square.
It feels amazing. We've worked so hard for this and now we've made it and we're first place. There's so much time and effort put into this car, so much friendships that were put on the line. but it was all, every single second of it was worth it.
The level of the competition was so high with all the high-performing machines, and a lot of top cars didn't survive the event. So we were happy to finish, and we're even happier to be on the podium.
Back at Bragg Park, Team Michigan is arriving. But inches before the finish line, they're stopped by race officials.
So, I worked in old time before. They told me that we have one house in the circuit.
The final judgment on Michigan's penalty has come down.
Is that it?
Just get out.
They will need to sit out an hour before they can finish the race.
We had to serve some penalties. And that was it was pretty frustrating, especially on the, we questioned the basis of some of the penalties, and in the end, they didn't affect the placement, but actually, you know, I'm not gonna talk about that.
Michigan is followed by Top Dutch, Kogakuen, and then Sonnenwagen, who, despite their terrible crash, were still able to finish in an astonishing sixth place.
So before joining the Solar team, every one of us was just a normal engineering student, some kind of nerds. And now, when you see this challenge, it's crazy to see that we have become like action movie stars.
What an incredible journey has it been. I think we learned why the organization called it a challenge and not a race. Every team kept their head up, and that is something everybody should be proud of. I'm also very proud of my team. We always dreamed of this trophy, and now people will say you have to beat the Belgians to get that trophy, and it's not, you have to beat the Dutch.
There's so much more to this race than just the car. It's a whole game of strategy and sacrifices and hard work and dedication of so many different people. It's special. Everyone's so dedicated and is just going for it with every single fiber in their body is just pointed towards that first place.
The race has come to a close, but the cutting edge tech that went into the cars will be analyzed and perfected for years to come. Time will tell which of these innovations will be adopted by the market. But technology from past events has been game-changing.
I believe all the teams can solve the global warming problems.
Thank you. Congratulations.
That's our aim and that's our work. Yes.
Agoria might have won the race, but all of us might one day reap the rewards of this year's World Solar Challenge.